Neon Genesis Evangelion. This is an anime series I picked up last year and I instantly fell in love with, despite my more than critical stance on older anime within this genre. But how I feel about this anime is not the point of this video. Did you know Evangelion has two dubs? I sure didn't. When I was experiencing the series alongside with someone else, I had found that I'd been watching what is titled the ADV dub, and my friend had been watching the more accessible Netflix dub. Now hold up, let's go back a bit. Back in November 26, 2018, Netflix had acquired the streaming rights to Neon Genesis Evangelion, and its film to go along with it, The End of Evangelion. And on June 21st, 2019, they finally released it to the platform, but to my surprise, they actually completely redubbed the original ADV lines. According to the Evangelion fandom wiki, original voice actors of Shinji, Spike Spencer, and Asuka, and Amanda Wynn Lee, had gone on record to say they were open to audition, but to my knowledge, they never did. With the whole cast having new voices, this actually can differ the experience audiences have with Evangelion. But enough of this information word vomit, let's actually see the differences. Before we get into this fully, I'd like to highlight the new voice actors. Shinji Ikari is voiced by Casey Mongolio. The only role I can really cross-reference is the performance of the gayest angel in fiction, the angel devil from Chainsaw Man. And now, he voices the most bisexual boy in existence. So, yeah, the shoe fits. Asuka is voiced by Stephanie McKeon, who's a stage actor as well, so that's awesome. But she honestly has no notable roles because who the hell is Sandy O'Shea? Misato is voiced by Kerry Kiernan, who actually has some more notable roles like Asuka from Berserk, some Naruto side characters, a Dangdan Ruffin character, and most notable of all, Vogel 7 from Earth Defense Force, World Brothers. Like, what a classic. Lastly, our one-third of Lilith, Rei Ayanami. Rein Bartley, who gives us this rendition of her voice. With her not having many notable roles, holy crap, it's Shoko from Jujutsu Kaisen. For this video, we'll be taking various clips from Evangelion and seeing which dub does it better. And if I think one is better, it gets a point. In the end, we'll see which dub gets more points. Now let's see which one comes out on top.
Why won't it sink?
Only an Ava can beat it.
What?
Something.
Well, put it on! Don't stand there! Get moving!
No way! Does Misato know about this?
I'll get her permission after the fact. Stop peeking, you stupid lech! Why is it all boys are idiots and so horny all of the time?
Why can't we sink it?
Guess you're pretty helpless without an Ava.
Let's go. Are you ready? You're coming with. Is that clear?
Is that okay? Shouldn't we get Ms. Misato's permission?
I'll get her permission after my victory.
Alright, so off rip, the differences in the direction each voice actor took is pretty jarring, and it's why those who viewed either one for the first time have such a heated debate about which one is better, because they're both solid performances. To be clear, I am not a definitive dub master, these are just my opinions, and if you like either one, more power to you. These voice actors clearly tried their hardest, and I appreciate all of them. So let's start with Asuka. In the ADV dub, I love her clear, striking energy, and how loud and bold she is. This is thanks to Tiffany Grant and her great voice acting skills. Fun fact, as many Evangelion fans know, Asuka is actually a German girl, and the voice actor herself actually knows some German. Slight correction here. She is actually very fluent in German, not just like a couple of words. She's actually a great German speaker. I'm kind of dumb. So this allows for Asuka to have moments where she slips German into her English sentences, and it's just perfect for her character. As for the Netflix dub Asuka, I have a few words. I do like how she sounds her age and young, because oh my god, in the old dub, some people just sound like adults when they're 12 years old. But I feel like a lot of energy is left out of the delivery, which when it comes to Asuka, you need to let out all that energy as she's one of the most in-your-face characters in the show. But still, not bad at all. It's a very solid performance. Shinji was fine in both of these clips, but he only had one line, and once we get more lines from him, I'll talk about how I feel, as the main character's voice is pretty important. One thing that is distinctly different is Toji and his interactions with the captains on the ship. I understand the Netflix dub's decision to keep their lines closed to grunts and muffles, just sounds that can be only made with your mouth closed, but this is anime. I don't really strive for realism, and Toji's quick and sharp had me laughing so loud, so I think it's final for this clip. ADV is getting the win. 1 point.
Say that. Just don't say that you have nothing else. Just don't say that. And don't say goodbye when you leave on a mission. It's just too sad.
Why are you crying? I'm very sorry. I don't know what I should do or feel at a time like this.
Why don't you just try smiling?
Are you okay? Ayanami! Please don't do that. Please don't say something like I have nothing else. Do you understand? And don't say something sad like farewell whenever you walk away.
Why are you crying, Ikari? Please forgive me. In situations like these, I don't know how to respond or act.
Smiling would be a good start.
Now this one surprised me. Going into this, I had a clear bias towards the ADV dub, as that is what I watched first, and seeing a lot of the Netflix dub was off-putting to me. But oh my, the Netflix dub takes the cake here. Let's start off with Senji. Listen, Spike, I love you, ma'am, but there was no emotion in these lines. Also, wouldn't it be his fault, but the lines are way too direct, like stating something is too sad is not good dialogue. But Casey took this scene to emotional heights my eyes weren't prepared for. Senji's screams sound like an actual child's, and they sound so real. The emotion is laid on so thick with every line. Rei was good in both. I'll always prefer the ADV, but in this scene, they both do amazing. Both have amazing takes as well. In the ADV, Rei always sounds weak and confused. But in the Netflix dub, she sounds more robotic and monotone. Just a small difference, but I had to point it out. But the writing in Netflix dub carries such tiny lines too. As you maybe noticed, in the Netflix dub, Rei refers to Senji as Ikari, which shows how she only views Senji as Gendo's son, and not his own being yet, which is excellent in my opinion. So good on you, Netflix. You got this win. 1 point.
Crying isn't going to solve anything either!
You hate yourself, don't you? That's why you hurt others. Deep down, you know you suffer more when you cause someone else pain than if you just let yourself get hurt. But Shinji, that was your decision, so it makes it a valid choice. Realize that you do have options. Then, accept the choices you've made.
But you're not me! You don't know what I have to go through! You don't understand!
So fucking what if I'm not you?! That doesn't mean it's okay for you to give up! If you do, I'll never forgive you as long as I live. God knows I'm not perfect either. I've made tons of stupid mistakes and later I regretted them. And I've done it over and over again, thousands of times. A cycle of hollow joy and vicious self-hatred.
Promise me.
Yes.
See you soon. That was a grown-up kiss. We'll do the rest when you get back, okay?
Stop it! Crying won't fix any of your problems!
You hate yourself. That's why you hurt others. You do it because you know the pain it brings you is far harsher than the pain anyone else can do to you. No matter what happens, what follows is the result of your own decisions, Shinji. And that's something meaningful.
You don't know anything about me! You're just a stranger!
I'm a stranger to you? Fine, I don't care! You want to quit, is that it? If you don't do anything right now, I won't ever forgive you! I will curse your name until the day I die! Who you think you are right now isn't everything. You realize how wrong you are thinking like that and then regret it. I'd be elated one second, then hate myself the next in an endless cycle. But I moved on. Promise me that.
take care of yourself. That's how grown-ups kiss. We'll do the rest when you get back, all right?
Sorry if the clips are cut up badly. I'm trying to avoid the copyright police. Anyway, the scene in both versions hits just as hard, so everything past here is just nitpicking or praising the tinier of details. Allison Keith absolutely kills the scene as Misato in the ADV dub. There's so many emotions coming out of this performance. Sadness, regret, sorrow, anger. She brings this scene all together. And her snap at Senji, the anger in that performance was absolutely insane and had my jaw glued to the floor on first viewing. And all of this to compare to the Netflix dub, Kiri's performance feels a lot weaker. Along with the general message of Misato not being too related to Senji like the ADV dub is, and her snapping at Senji not really having much emotion and being delivered too flat. Other than that though, the scene is amazing, and for my praise of the ADV version, I have to say, it wins. 1 point. Editing note again, the Netflix version gets a little smidgen of a point because it made this meme a thing.
You hate yourself. That's why you hurt others. You do it because you know.
Girl, you know you don't relate to Evelyn Jr. And girl, shut the hell up.
Huh? Oh, jeez.
Pathetic.
What are you doing on my unit, too?
What are you talking about? You're the one who fell on me!
You're the one who lost time first, Duke!
Image training for today's battle!
Oh, image training, I just bet! Liar! I know you tried to kid me while I was sleeping!
You cheat! You were awake!
I was just kidding! Did you really kiss me? Oh!
No, I didn't! I stopped!
Those darn kids are embarrassing us again.
Both Avas are accounted for.
Not again!
Appalling.
Doing to my unit too?
What are you even talking about? You're the one crushing me.
You miss your mark at the very last second. Don't deny it.
And what was that last night? You trying to pull a fast one?
I was visualizing how I was going to fight today's battle.
You liar! You tried to sneak a kiss while I was asleep.
What? You were faking that whole time?
Actually, you were trying to kiss me. You did kiss me, didn't you?
No, I didn't. I stopped midway.
Pervert! Sixth grade maniac!
This is a total embarrassment.
I had to pull out another silly scene, because it was getting way too serious in here. This is actually the toughest one so far, because both of these have such great moments within themselves. Misato's aw jeez, and the ADV is silly, but the total dismay in her voice in the Netflix dub makes this scene even funnier. In the ADV dub, Spike and Tiffany have such great chemistry in their scenes together. Apparently, the chemistry was so good they were offered to make a PSA for AIDS, in which they had to make really lewd noises that they were way too good at that I never even had a chance to hear on radio. Let's continue. But even with this, the script in the Netflix one I find a bit funnier, and Casey and Stephanie have great chemistry as well. So for the first time in forever, this is going to be a tie.
So, what are you doing for the rest of the day?
Well, usually when tests are over, I'll just take a shower and go home. But I don't really want to go home these days.
The fact that you have a place where you can return, home, will lead you to happiness. That is a good fact.
It's time.
Time to go?
Yeah. I have to go to bed.
With me?
No, I think you have your own room that they gave you, I mean.
You know, pain is something that man must endure in his heart. And since the heart feels pain so easily, some believe life is pain. You are delicate like glass, especially your heart.
I am?
Yes, and worth earning my empathy.
Empathy?
I'm saying I love you.
What are you up to?
Well, with the routine testing done, all that's left to do is take a shower, then head home. But to be honest, I don't like going home. These days.
The fact that you have a home to return to, that's something to be happy about. It's a good thing.
It's time.
Time's up already?
Yeah. We gotta go to bed.
With you?
No! I think there's a room ready for you, Kaworu. Just for you.
Humans live with a constant feeling of pain inside of their hearts. But their hearts are sensitive to pain, so it makes living difficult. Their hearts are delicate like glass, yours especially.
You think so?
Yes, you're worthy of my grace.
Your grace?
I'm saying I like you.
Now finally, probably the main scene that fuels this war of dubs, Karu and Senji. Both of these scenes are sweet and full of the godly nature of Karu. You may wonder why everyone doesn't like the Netflix dub of this scene, and it's only for one main reason. The fact that Karu says like instead of love. Now I understand this. Queer erasure in media is the worst possible thing, but I don't see it this way. In fact, Karu acts a lot more tender and sweet to Senji in the Netflix dub, and the using of the word like fits the scenario of them really just meeting for the first time. This is one of their first conversations. But for me, the most distinct difference is Karu's realization about humanity and about Senji. Their hearts are delicate like glass, yours especially. Yes, you're worthy of my grace. These quotes resonate within me so deeply, and it shows Karu's pure love and care for Senji. It's horribly romantic considering what's about to happen to Karu. So here, the Netflix dub takes 2 points, as this scene is the reason it's widely hated, so the fact it won for me, it deserves that extra point. So, there we have it. All scenes I lined up for scoring. Adding the points up, ADV has 3 points, and Netflix has 4. Netflix won this dubbing competition. Conclusion? Obviously, these handful of scenes do not live up for the quality of either version throughout the total runtime of either show. Like, there's 24 episodes and I only showed 5 clips. So while I still lean to the ADV side of dubbing, this video really convinced me to rewatch Evangelion but through the Netflix dub, because wow, the voice acting crew really kills some of the serious scenes, and brings the emotional moments to heights I never even thought of. And to those of you out there who have only watched one of the dubs, I suggest that you rewatch it but through the other dub. I'd really love to see your guys' opinions in the comments below. Wow, this video took a long time to make. This is just me off script at the end of this video, just leaving a message for y'all, as this is my first video. And tell me what you guys think of it. I'd love to get feedback, advice, anything. Like, I worked really hard on this, and if enough people like this, I may continue this. I really enjoyed doing this and just working hard at it all day, doing research. Feels like doing a school assignment, but for fun. Anyways, I will see you guys in the next video that I do not know what I'm going to talk about yet, but I will find out soon. Bye-bye.